Hello and welcome back to my channel. I am Upasana Taneja. In today's video, we are going to discuss part 2 of our chapter Knowing Our Numbers of class 6th. Part 1 I have already discussed with you all. So, I hope you understood that. So, we are going to continue exercise 2 of this chapter and we are going to deal in measurement today. So, stay tuned with me. So, you know, if we are having a line and we need to measure that, how will you measure? You know that you have a scale to measure. Okay, for measuring this you will say either we use some units for measuring. Okay, suppose we use centimeters, we use this, we use millimeters, we use meters. Okay, this is millimeters. Okay, and this is centimeters. We use these units and suppose we are traveling from one city to another city or one country to another country, then what do we need? We need a very bigger quantity. We cannot measure by scale. Okay, so how do we measure? For those long distances, we use unit kilometers, which is largest unit for calculating distances. Okay, so how do we write our measurements in these units? You know that there is some relation between these units. Sometimes what we need to convert to units. Okay, sometimes we are having a question and we are having two units in the same question. We cannot solve that question unless both the units are same. Okay, we cannot have one digit in centimeter and one in measurement in meters. So we need to convert. So for converting we have some rules. What are those rules? I'm going to tell you so that you can easily convert. If we are having 1 kilometer and we need to go to meters, we need to convert in meters, and we are having meters and we need to convert to, I will write small, we need to convert to centimeter. Okay, and then from centimeter we want to go to millimeter. I'm just writing mm. Okay, so we have km, kilometer, m, meter, cm, centimeter, and mm, millimeter. We have a particular rule for this. How do we convert these units? If you are having 1 kilometer and you need to convert it in meters, what do you need? You need to multiply. If we will go there, we will just multiply. Okay, I will show you with examples also. For meter to centimeter, we use multiply by 100. Why? Because there are 100 centimeters in 1 meter. Okay, and there are 10 millimeters in 1 centimeter. How can I write this? 1 km is equal to 1000 meters, 1 meters is equal to 100 centimeters, and 1 centimeter is equal to 10 millimeter. It is not at all difficult to learn. You can just learn KMCM. Okay, KMCM, kilometers, millimeters, centimeters, millimeters, and simply follow this rule. 1110. Suppose you are having 5 kilometer and you need to convert it in centimeter, and you are having 5 kilometer, you need to convert it in meters. Okay, so 5 kilometers will be 5000. We will simply multiply it with 1000 because there are 1000 meters in 1 kilometer. So 5 kilometer will be 5 into 1000 meters. Okay, if we will go there, we will multiply. If we will come here, if we will move left to right, right to left, we will divide. If we will move right, left to right, we will multiply. Okay, let's see how. 5 kilometers in centimeters. Now see carefully. 5 kilometers where do we need to go? Kilometers to centimeters. Okay. With which quantity we need to multiply? We need to multiply once with 1000 and once with 100. What will become? 5 into 1000 into 100 centimeters. Are you getting me? If we are going from kilometers to centimeters, we will multiply once by 1000 and once by 100. What will come? It will be 5 lakhs centimeters in 5 kilometers. And if you need to find it millimeters, what will you do? You will multiply, see, once by 1000, once by 100 and once by 10. Then it will become millimeters. Okay, so I think you are getting this. If you are facing any difficulty, please ask me in comment section. Okay, so now by these rules we can convert from higher units to lower units. Okay, these were higher because these are used to measure higher distances, yeah, long distances. Okay, but for small distances, yeah, for small measurements, we use these quantities, centimeters. If we want to measure a line, okay, we will not measure this in kilometers. We will measure this in centimeters. Okay, so it depends that how long distance or how long line or how long you want to measure. For these, you need units. Okay, suppose now you want to measure some weight. You are carrying a book or you are carrying a duster. You want to measure its weight. So for lighter quantities, what will we use? And for heavier quantities, what will we use? We will see here now. Now I think you have understood that how do we convert. If we are going from left to right, we will multiply. And if we are going from right to left, we will divide. Okay, but we are just converting from higher units to lower units. Now see, if you want to measure weight, okay, suppose you are carrying a weight of, suppose you bought some bananas or some apples, you will buy some in measurement. Okay, you will weigh, it's 1 kg or 2 kg or 3 kg. Suppose I am having a pen, this is also having weight. Okay, so how much it weight? We use grams. For measuring weight, what we use? We use grams. For lighter weights, we use milligrams or grams. For heavier things, we use kilograms. Similarly, for liquid things, you use liters. Suppose you buy milk. You buy milk in liters. 1 liter or 2 liter or 3 liters. Okay. So, 1000 liters make 1 kiloliters for very, very heavier quantities, or for very, very, very much quantities, we use kiloliters. So these are measurements for weights, and these are for liquids. And we have already studied for distances. And here I can write for you, 1 kilogram is equal to 1000 grams, and 1 gram is equal to 1000 milligrams. Okay. 1 kiloliter is equal to 1000 liter and 1 liter is equal to 1000 milliliter. Now it depends what quantity you have. Suppose you have 60 grams and you need to convert it in milligrams. What will you do? What will you do? When we go left to right, grams to milligrams, we'll multiply by this quantity. 60 into 1000, we'll have 60,000. Milligrams. Similarly, if we are having 5 liters of milk and we need to convert in milliliters, what will we do? We'll just divide or multiply 5 by 1000 and we'll get 5000 milliliters. Now, suppose you have 500 liters of milk and you need to convert in kiloliters. Now you are going liters to kiloliters. What will you do? You will divide. This will be 500 upon 1000 and it will be 1 by 2 kiloliters. Okay. So this is how we measure distances, how we measure weight, how we measure liquid. So these all are measurements. Okay, so next we come to our topic, estimation. What is estimation? How do we add, how do we subtract if we estimate the numbers? We are going to see that. Let's see that topic. So now comes the topic of estimation. What is estimation? How do we estimate the things? Estimation means round off the things. Okay, suppose you are going to a shop and you are buying some chocolates for you, and they cost you around 5.99. What will they do? They'll not take 5.99, they'll take 6 rupees from you. And suppose they cost 5.22, they'll not take 5.22, they'll charge 5 rupees. How are they charging 5 or 6? How do they round off the things? How do they estimate? Suppose if the quantity is between 50 and 60, if we are rounding in tens, we can round in ones, we can round off in tens, we can round off in hundreds. Suppose the thing is between 50 and 60 and the number is 53. Okay, this is on a very high level of estimation. In general, you will give 53, but if we are having a very large calculation, what we'll do for calculating it fast, we just round off the things. For rounding off, if we are having 53, we'll take 50. If we are having 56 or 57, 58, we'll take around 60. We'll take that 60. Suppose you want to add two quantities, okay? Suppose we have 478 plus 320. And we want to add these things by round off, by estimation. We want to add so many quantities. So what we do, we just estimate the things. Okay, so how will we do? We'll take it 500 and 300 approx. We'll say approx 800. 800 approx. Or we are saying we just estimated these things. Why did we estimate? That is for faster calculation, you can say. Or suppose we are having so much calculation, so we just round off the things. Suppose we are having 1,000 guests in a party and we are going to calculate the cost per plate for every guest and what will be the cost. So we just don't count it, we just don't calculate it one by one. What we do? We just take estimation. Okay, so this is how we estimate. Suppose we are estimating in thousands. Suppose we have 4256 plus 3940. We need to add this. What will we do? This is 4000 plus 4000, approx 8000. Okay, we don't need to add it if we are estimating. What will we do? We'll just take, this is 42. We are estimating around thousands. So this lies between 4000 and 5000. Okay. And it is more near to 4000, so we'll take 4000 plus this is between 3000 and 4000, and this is more near to 4000, so we'll take 4000. So approximately it will become 8000. So this is how we estimate. This is how we add by estimation. Similarly, we can subtract also by estimation. How will we subtract this? We will take 500 minus 300, approx 200. What we are doing? We are estimating. We are adding or subtracting by estimation. Okay. Suppose you want to multiply the things. Suppose you multiply this. So what will you take? You will take by estimation. This will be 1800. You don't need to multiply if you are just estimating. Why we need estimation? I have told you so many times that we need estimation for higher calculations. But we should know what is estimation. That's why we are learning in a small way. Okay. So this is how we add, subtract and multiply. and I think you are having so many questions in your books, and you can try those questions with the help of these tricks, and you can tell me your doubts in the comment section below. Okay, so next we'll move to, so now I'm going to explain you Roman numerals. We can write the numbers in Roman numerals also. So what is, how do we write in Roman numbers? Like, we know the counting in Roman numerals. This is 1, this is 2, this is 3. 1, 2, 3, and it's so simple. If you will learn till 10, it's very easy to write further till 100. Okay, 4, 5, 6, this is 7, 8, 9, and 10. Okay, now you will have to learn this, you will have to practice if you don't know. Okay, now next we are moving to 11. What is 11? This is 10, this is 10. 10 and 1 will be 11. 10 and 2 will be 12. 10 and 3 will be 13. 10 and 4 will be 14. 10 and 5, 15. 10 and 6 is 16. 10 and 7 is 17. 10 and 8 is 18. 10 and 9 is 19. And 10 and 10 is 20. This is how we write in Roman numbers. So next, similarly, we have 20 now. If we continue like this, 21, and this will be 22, and you can continue and you will get till 30. Similarly, in 30 you can continue 31 and till 32, 33 you will triple X, okay, and 34, 35, okay, 36, 37, and up to so on. How will you write 40 now? It's tricky little bit. Now you should know what is 50. 50 is L. Okay, if we write X before L, it will become 40. And if we write X after L, it will become 60. What will be 70? LXX. Similarly, we'll move till 100 and C is 100. Okay, what is 100? C. And similarly, 90 will be XC. Okay, one line is missing here. It will be LXX, that is 80. Okay, so we can write it XL till, this is 40. Now, XL1, XL2, XL3, XL4, XL5, up to so on, it will go till L. Okay, similarly, now L1, L2, L3, and similarly continue like this, we'll come till 60. Similarly, LX1, similarly we'll go LXX1, LXXX1, and up to so on, and 90 will be XC, and 100 is C. So this is how we write counting in Roman numbers. So I think first chapter is completed, and you can try questions from your book, and you can ask your doubts in comment section below. And if you are liking, then please subscribe my channel and hit the bell button also, and do visit my channel, and I am going to continue 6 class maths. Okay, and thank you for watching my video.